taken from the book of Deuteronomy. Side of your Lord. Then Moses went up from the plains of Moab to Mount Nebo, the peak of Pisgah, which faces Jericho. And the Lord showed him all the land, Galilee, and as far as Dan, all Naphtali, and the land of Ephraim and Manasseh, all the land of Judah, as far as the western sea, the Negev, the plain, the valley of Jericho, the city of palms, and as far as Zor. The Lord said to him, "This is the land about which I promised on oath to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I will give it to your descendants. I have let you see it with your own eyes, but you shall not cross over." So therefore, in the land of Moab, Moses, the servant of the Lord, died, as the Lord had said. And he was buried in a valley in the land of Moab, opposite Bethor. To this day, no one knows the place of his burial. Moses was 120 years old when he died, yet his eyes were undimmed and his vigor unabated. The Israelites wept for Moses in the plains of Moab for 30 days, till they had completed the period of grief and mourning for Moses. Now Joshua, son of Nun, was filled with the spirit of wisdom, since Moses had laid his hands upon him. And so the Israelites gave him their obedience, just as the Lord had commanded Moses. A reading taken from the book of the great prophet Isaiah. Therefore says the Lord God, "My servants shall eat, but you shall go hungry. My servants shall drink, but you shall be thirsty. My servants shall rejoice, but you shall be put to shame. My servants shall shout for joy of heart, but you shall cry out for grief of heart and howl for anguish of spirit. You will leave your name for a curse to my chosen ones. And when the Lord God slays you and calls the servants by another name, whoever invokes a blessing in the land shall bless by the God of truth. Whoever takes an oath in the land shall swear by a God of truth. For the hardships of the past shall be forgotten and hidden from my eyes."
Thank you.
That I am not responsible for the blood of any of you. For I did not shrink from your proclaiming to the entire plan of God. Keep watch over yourselves and over the whole flock of the Holy Spirit, which has appointed you overseers, in which you tend to the church God that he had acquired with his own blood. I know that after my departure, savage wolves will come among you, and they will not spare the flock. And from your own group, men will come forward, perverting the truth to draw the disciples away after them. So be vigilant and remember that for 3 years, night and day, I unceasingly admonished each of you with tears. And now I condemn you to God and to that gracious word of his that can build you up and give you the inheritance among all who are consecrated. I have never wanted anyone's gold or silver or clothing. You will know well that these are very hands have served my needs and my companions. In every way, I have shown you that by hard work of that sort, you must help the weak and keep in mind the words of the Lord Jesus, who himself said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." And when he had finished speaking, he knelt down and prayed with them all. They were all weeping loudly as they threw their hands around Paul and kissed him, for they were deeply distressed that he had said that they would never see his face again. Then they escorted him to the ship.
Remember your leaders who spoke the word of God to you. Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Do not be carried away by all kinds of strange teaching. It is good to have our hearts strengthened by grace and not by foods, which do not benefit those